Welcome to another episode of Old Sneelock's Workshop. Some of you guys have asked me about sharpening a one-man crosscut saw. There's a lot of variation on crosscut saws. There's lance tooth and perforated lance tooth and a variety of different combination teeth. This one is called a champion tooth, and that's the one I'm going to talk about today. Most one-man saws have a couple of unique features when compared to a two-man saw. One-man saw typically has a D-shaped handle, like this one. That allows you to grab a hold of the saw and control it when you're cutting through a piece of wood in a cradle, like bucking up firewood. It also can come with an auxiliary handle. If you're buying a new one, this is cost extra. If you're buying an antique, you're probably going to get one that looks like this one, and you're going to have to replace the wood. The auxiliary handle can be mounted near the D-shaped handle. That gives you an extra grip when you're cutting up wood in a cradle, like bucking firewood. It can also be removed by turning the handle, and then that loosens up the pin. You pull the pin out. Then being careful of the teeth, you slide the pin through the hole out at the tip of the saw. And you tighten it up, and now you have a saw that can be used by two men. The auxiliary handle out here gives the other guy a handle to pull on, and you get to guide the saw with a D-shaped handle. Is it a two-man saw for is it an equivalent of a two-man saw? No, it's not. It cuts very well, and it'll work on smaller stock, but this is a 42-inch blade. You're not going to cut down one of the giants in the forest with it. This is a champion tooth saw. It has alternating rakers and crosscut teeth. The crosscut teeth slice both sides of the kerf, and then the raker comes through and pops the chip out left by the crosscut teeth. So there's this very specific way to sharpen this saw. If you haven't seen one before, this is a crosscut saw. It's called a panel saw. It's a little shorter. This one's made by the Henry Diston and Sons. It's a number 12. Very cool saw. But if you tried to cut trees with it, you're going to be kind of disappointed. For one thing, it's got too fine of teeth. That's pretty obvious. But also, when you're cutting heavy wood and it's green, you want to have something that clears out the chips easily. This is for cutting thinner wood. The deep gullets in between the teeth on the one-man crosscut saw allows the chips to gather in there so you can cut wider, thicker chunks of wood. You can only cut a piece of wood about half the length of the saw because you want to be able to get the chips out of this center part. So it has to be able to exit the wood as you're cutting. But the big teeth allow you to take a bigger cut, have more sawdust, and it lets you cut faster through green wood. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up. When you click the subscribe button, click the little setting wheel next to it. That lets you tell YouTube to send you an email every time I upload a video. That way you won't miss a single one. I'll see you on the next video.